People often ask me how I farm gold in Guild Wars 2, and honestly, I don't farm gold. Yes, you heard that right, I don't actively participate in gold farms. I prefer to participate in meta events that grant a lot of gold. Usually, participation in these events give you a certain amount of a specific material or a currency, which you can spend on something else you can make gold with. So let's have a look at three great meta maps to make gold on. A small disclaimer before we start, I'm not claiming that these are the best methods of making gold, but these maps grant you a good amount of gold without having to grind for it. Also, some maps have been considered gold farming maps for over 5 years, so don't worry about this video getting outdated. Alright, let's start with the latest addition to the gold farming maps, Drizzlewood Coast. Drizzlewood Coast is one of the newest maps in Guild Wars 2 and was added on the 26th of May of 2020 with the No Quarter Living World update. Like all other maps in this video, this map does not have a set time to start, meaning that players on the map control when the meta of the map progresses. The concept of the map is very simple. You start at the southern part of the map and you will have to progress to the northern part of the map. You progress by participating in events to capture all bases around the map. Once you have captured all bases, the last event will start. Drizzlewood Coast is in many ways profitable. First, you have your normal loot and event rewards, nothing special here. But before you start smashing your buttons during the events, don't forget to pick up a magic find bonus near the waypoint. You can get this bonus for 100 war supplies at the war supplies vendor. If you don't have these 100 war supplies just yet, just do the meta once or twice without a buff. You will get enough of these war supplies after one or two runs. This will increase the chance of having better drops during the events in Drizzlewood Coast. You can then further increase this buff with a birthday booster or food that grants magic find. That's actually good practice for every map in this video. Also, while you are at this merchant, don't forget to declare your support to any of the legions. Collecting commendations for these legions will increase your standing with these legions. The higher standing or rating you have with these legions, the better the rewards will be. You can easily find what tier of standing you have in the achievement panel. Each legion has its own set of tasks tied to it. But next to those tasks, you can also get these char commendations by participating in the meta and looting the chests after you have captured a camp. If you progress in these tiers, the rewards will also increase. For example, the Ash Legion gives you a Venom box at tier 15. These boxes contain 100 Venom sacks of different crafting tiers, which you can then use for crafting or by selling on a trading post. Each Legion has their own set of materials. The Ash Legion gives you Venom sacks, the Blood Legion gives you blood, Flame Legion gives you dust, and the Iron Legion gives you claws. For the maximum amount of profit, check the trading post what materials are currently high in demand and declare your support based on that. The next thing you want to do is to participate in as many events you see. A big part of the reward system in Drizzlewood Coast is based on participation. It is similar to maps like Dragonstand in the Heart of Thorns expansion. The more you participate in events, the more your rewards will increase. But also, the more camps the players on your map have captured, the more material chests you will get. Every 10 minutes, you will get your reward based on your participation. In the bottom right of your screen, right above the minimap, you can see when the next reward chest will pop up. To maximize the rewards from this system, make sure to enter the map as soon as the meta begins. This way you can start grinding up that participation bonus and get the maximum amount of profit when the rest of the map starts capturing more and more camps. These chests all grant materials from all tiers. So the contents of this chest could either be between tier 1 materials and tier 6 materials. These could also be very useful if you are crafting a specific legendary or ascended item. The third and last element that makes Drizzlewood Coast profitable are the after meta events. They aren't formally called after meta events, but they happen after the main meta of the map. So I will call them after meta events. After you have defeated Nicobar, Vision and Renoa, a number of char appear all over the map. These char are called cache keepers, and after you defeat them, a storage room will open up. These storage rooms have caches you can open with a cache key. These cache keys can be bought at merchants that spawn right after you have cleared a camp or at the southern waypoint of the map. You can buy 5 of them each day for war supplies, but after you have bought 5 of these keys, the price will drastically increase. You also have a chance of getting these keys in chests you get from participation in meta events on the map. Anyway, these caches you open have a ton of materials, which you could then sell for gold on the trading post. So doing the 4 things I've mentioned before, magic boost and support, clever event participation, and the after-meta events will give you a ton of materials. If you do the map for the first time, you will get the earlier tiers of the achievements rather fast. There are rewards tied to these achievements as well, but you can only do them once and they are not repeatable. You will also get char field homing beacons from events and chests you loot. Use these beacons to find lost char supply drops which can contain additional rewards. You can easily do them in between events. The amount of gold I made on this map is variable. It really depends if I get lucky with the drops and whether I get rewards from declaration to a legion. But if I can make a rough estimate and if you sell all materials you get, I think you can easily make between 10 to 25 gold per meta. I know this is a big difference, but it's hard to give an exact number. Personally, I think it's also a really fun map and it is highly repeatable. So it stays fun even if you do it multiple times a day. And the next map is Dragonfall. No, stop. Don't click away just yet, because you are going to return in a day leaving a comment how about non-profitable it was. Nah, I'm just making a joke, but Dragonfall is also a very profitable map. In contrast to Drizzlewood Coast, it does not matter when and where you join. You can join halfway through the meta and it can still be profitable. Also, this map is community driven, meaning, like I said before, that other players will start the meta and control when and where it starts. It is not time gated by event timers or anything. The profitable part of the map comes from the volatile magic you collect. Once you complete an event in Dragonfall, it will grant you between 5 to 10 pieces of volatile magic. Usually about 7 to be precise. This may not sound like a lot, but it ramps up pretty quick if you participate in numerous events. Also, everything you kill gives about 2 to 3 pieces of volatile magic. Not all enemies that belong to an event will grant you volatile magic, but about 80 to 90% of the enemies do. We have to make a difference between events here. You have your regular events that are along or on the road, which give you standard rewards, but you also have meta progression events. These give you the volatile magic we talked about, but it also gives you a Mistborn key. These Mistborn keys can be spent on Mistborn coffers. Three of these chests will spawn right after a meta progression event. These coffers contain Mistborn modes, which can be used in crafting, but in our case, making gold, you want to consume them. Once every 3 coffers you open, you will get a guaranteed rare item. This is usually in the form of an orb or more Mistborn modes. You can sell these orbs on the trading post to make a good amount of gold. You also have a chance of getting the Gift of Irene, which allows you to craft unique ascended weapons. If you didn't get that by the 1000th chest you opened, you will get one for certain. That's a nice little fact to know. After the Dragonfall meta, there are a bunch of these coffers you can loot right away. Once again, more loot you can sell on the trading post and more Mistborn modes you can consume. But after the meta, there is more. Stick close to your commander because he will lead you through a number of champion events. Every champion will then spawn additional Mistborn coffers. Once again, loot all of them to maximize your profit. You will eventually run out of keys, so make sure to participate in as many events during the meta. This way you won't run out of keys at a fast rate. Once you are done with all of that, make sure to salvage your greens and blues and consume your Mistborn modes. Sell your exotic items on the trading post, and now it's time to put that volatile magic to good use. Run up to the Mist Warden Quartermaster near the Pact Command waypoint. At this vendor, you will spend your volatile magic on trophy shipments. Depending on your drops, you will make a profit or a break even. Combining this with the Mistborn coffers and doing all the events, this can give you about 10 to 15 gold on an average run. There are reports of people, especially in the farming community, that make about 30 gold per run. Check out the description for that Reddit thread. And in terms of volatile magic, you earn between 1500 and 2000 pieces. It's definitely worth your time. Oh, and a few tips beforehand. Don't forget to get the Karmic Retribution and the Empowerment bonus to get more Karma and Spirit Shards whilst playing. The last map should not come as an unexpected one. It's the Silver Wastes. The Silver Wastes is one of the best options for new and free-to-play players. Also, when people tell you to farm the Silver Wastes, they don't usually tell you the whole story, what makes it profitable. The concept of the Silver Wastes is also very simple. There are 4 forts with numerous events tied to it. The events all revolve around the idea of recapturing it and protecting it from Mordrem enemies. Nowadays, Guild Wars 2 players refer to the Silver Wastes as Reba. Reba stands for Red, Indigo, Blue and Amber. Each of these forts represent one of the colors I just mentioned. If you see Reba in a Looking for Group tab, you know you have found a Silver Wastes meta map. To maximize your profit, you want to participate in every event of every fort very briefly. Therefore, you must be quick. Getting one or just a few kills in a fort event is enough to get the reward of these events. It is wise to use a mount if you have the possibility. If you are a free-to-play player, consider using a profession that can provide a ton of swiftness or has a lot of mobility. For example, use your shouts on a guardian or use your infiltrator's arrow on a short bow whilst playing thief. Completing the events I just mentioned will also give you shovels and bandit skeleton keys. You can use the shovels to scan for bandit treasure and then dig them up. Once you have digged them up, you can open them with your bandit skeleton keys. Also, you will get a perseverance buff when you participate in events in the Silver Wastes. This buff can give you a +30% magic find and can stack up to 5 times. This will increase your chances of getting better loot. So your participation in events is very important in getting a ton of loot. After all Reba forts have completed their events, the forts will collapse and you will have to take out a number of bosses at those forts. Then, the Vine Rat spawns and you want to participate in this event too. The end chest of this event also gives you some nice loot. This, along with the Perseverance buff, will significantly increase your chances of getting better loot and will last if you stay for the next round of Silver Wastes. So, on your second run of the Silver Wastes on the same map as before, you will have a higher chance of getting more and better loot. And now it's time to follow your commander again. The commander will usually walk a specific route to dig up bandit chests. Once again, digging up these chests with 2 or 3 magic find buffs will increase your chances of getting better loot. The coin purses you get from these events contain crafting materials which you can then sell on a trading post. You could also open the coin purses on a lower level character to get gear that matches the level of that character. You can then salvage the gear to get crafting materials of a lower tier. In some occasions, lower tier crafting materials are worth more than higher tier crafting materials. For example, linen scraps, a tier 4 material, are worth more than silk scraps, a tier 5 material. A run of the Silver Wastes can grant you about 10 to 15 gold per run. There have been reports of people making 25 gold per run, but I would not consider myself that lucky. It all depends on the drops, which you can always increase with magic find buffs. In terms of time, I think the Silver Wastes has the shortest meta. Most players have known this map for years and there is always a Reba squad in the Looking for Group panel. Definitely a good map for free-to-play players and players with the expansions alike. So what do these three maps have in common and what makes them profitable? First, there are side achievements or rewards tied to them. For example, the Silver Wastes has the magic find buff based on participation, and this while the Drizzlewood Coast map has an allegiance you can pledge to and progress towards a ton of achievements. Second, they are all community driven. You can hop in at any time and the community decides when the meta starts. You don't have to wait for a specific time to start farming. Third, participation is profitable. For example, higher participation in the Drizzlewood Coast leads to higher rewards, and higher participation in the Silver Wastes leads to a higher magic find. And fourth, the longer you stay, the better the rewards. Again, the Silver Wastes gives you a magic find buff after you have defeated the Mordrem Vine Wrath. If you decide to do another run of the Silver Wastes, you have a chance of getting better rewards. Also, the after meta events in Dragonfall and the Drizzlewood Coast are very profitable if you have enough keys, which you can farm during the main meta event. Fifth and last, you decide what to do and what to spend it on. You can choose multiple paths on each map. You don't have to do the same events over and over. You can do events in the west today and do the ones in the east tomorrow. And all of this while you are still making profit. Also, you decide if you want to sell your materials and loot or if you want to keep them to craft ascended or legendary gear. I hope all of these will help you farm the gold you need for the item you want. Also, let me know why you are farming gold in the comments. And as per usual, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe for more Guild Wars 2 content and share this video with your guildies if you think it was helpful. Thank you all for watching and I hope to see you all in the next one. Peace.